I'm going to demonstrate how to run the OMS application locally with its workers and API servers using Temporal Cloud. I'll also show how to use the web application to process a more complex order, which involves multiple shipments and customer interaction because it includes an out-of-stock item. By default, the OMS uses the default namespace and expects to communicate with a temporal service running on localhost port 7233 without TLS. However, its design enables you to customize those settings by defining a few environment variables. That means that you can switch from a development server running on your laptop to Temporal Cloud without changing a single line of application code. I'll set four environment variables in the terminal where I start the worker. For convenience, the OMS uses the same variables I'd set to use the Temporal CLI with Temporal Cloud. The first one specifies the endpoint address for the namespace I'm using. This information is visible when viewing the namespace in Temporal Cloud. Here's the name of my namespace, and here's where I find the endpoint address. The next variable specifies the name of my namespace. Temporal Cloud requires the use of TLS, so next, I'll specify the location of my certificate. And finally, the location of my private key file for that certificate. I'll change to the directory with the OMS source code, now that the variables are set, and start the workers. Since I'm using Temporal Cloud, I don't need to run the Temporal service locally. However, I do need to define those same four environment variables with the same values in the terminal where I start the Order Management System's API servers. Now I'll change the directory with the OMS source, and then run the command to start the API servers. Finally, I'll start the web application that I'll use to demonstrate the OMS. Since this doesn't communicate with Temporal Cloud, I don't need to set those environment variables in this window. I'll navigate to the web application in this browser window, and in this one, I'll log into Temporal Cloud so that I can use its web UI to see the workflow executions corresponding to my order, charges, and shipments. I'll show the web application on top and the worker's terminal windows below that so you can see how the actions in the web application correspond to log messages emitted by the workers. I'll select the role of customer, begin a new order, and then click through the set of predefined orders until I locate one that has multiple items, one of which is a specific brand of shoe that, for demonstration purposes, is always out of stock. Now I'll submit the order to the OMS. The log message emitted by the worker, as well as the web application used by the customer, indicate that this order is on hold pending customer action. Since the order contains an item that's out of stock, the order management system offers an amended order that excludes this item. The customer must either accept the amended order or cancel it. The OMS also sets a timer, ensuring that the order will time out and the items will be returned to inventory if the customer doesn't respond quickly enough. For demonstration purposes, this timer has a duration of just 30 seconds, but because timers and temporal workflows are durable, you could change the duration to be several minutes, days, or even years. This illustrates one approach to providing a limited time offer, which is especially common for systems that process orders for tickets to concerts or sporting events. I'll click the Amend button here to proceed with the order. The terminal window shows several log messages in quick succession, indicating that it has started the workflow execution for the order, shipments, and charges. At the top of the customer's order detail page, I see a status of canceled for the unavailable item. Scrolling down, I see that this order groups the remaining items into two shipments, one from warehouse A and the other from warehouse B. Both shipments have a status of booked, indicating that a courier has agreed to deliver them but has not yet picked up either shipment from the warehouse. When I refresh the Temporal Cloud web UI, I see those five workflow executions in the namespace. Since further progress of this order now depends on the courier, I'll assume that role and view a list of available shipments. I'll show the workflow execution for this order in the Temporal web UI so that you can see updates as they happen. On the left, I can see the order data that was passed as input. The results aren't yet available since the order processing is still underway. These two moving lines represent the child workflows started for each shipment, which are still running. Now, I'll perform the courier actions for the first shipment. When I click the dispatch button, the worker emits a few log messages to the terminal, and the web UI shows a new icon representing the signal used to update the shipment status. I'll click that to show the details, which includes the shipment ID, status, and timestamp of this update. I'll close this, scroll up, and mark the shipment as delivered. Like before, I see output in the terminal and a new timeline icon for the signal. What's different is the line representing the shipment child workflow. It stopped moving and became solid green, indicating successful completion. I'll return to the workflows page, which will confirm this. The child workflow for this shipment is indeed complete. Now, I'll head back to where I was and process the other shipment. Just like before, I'll click the dispatch button, followed by the deliver button. Both of these send signals to update the status. Once I click that deliver button, the remaining child workflow for the shipment completes. Because this order contained two shipments, both of which have now been delivered to the customer, the workflow execution for the order also completes. The processing for this order is now finished.